My name is Eric Strebel. Welcome to another video of mine about industrial design. Today we're going to take a look at how to assemble a B9 Creator 3D printer. 3D printing has been one of the cornerstones of industrial design for about the last 15 years or so. It's really changed the way industrial designers make models and prototype products that consumers purchase today. Having a 3D printer in my design studio is a really big deal for me. It's going to allow me to make rapid prototypes of my own design work and take on work from other people and companies that need to have parts produced for whatever it is that they're designing. The way 3D printing works is that once a product's been modeled in CAD, you just export an STL file of that solid and feed it into the machine software. It slices it up and it makes a model. It's a pretty simple process. It sounds complicated, but it's pretty straightforward. And it's a huge, huge time saving. It allows you to make models in a matter of hours instead of days or weeks. It also allows you to build models and products with incredible accuracy and integration that just wasn't possible before. So if you wanted to integrate some electronics or a mechanical device into your product, in the old days, you had to do that by hand. You had to get a sample, you had to fit it together, make a model, everything was done by hand. Now everything's done on the computer. You can adjust it infinitely and keep working on it and tweaking it until it's just right. This printer that I'm assembling is called the B9 Creator. It's a DLP resin-based printer. It uses a liquid resin and a digital projector to shine into the vat of resin and create layer on layer on layer to build an object. And this video isn't so much about 3D printing as it is about actually building the machine. I just thought it was a cool idea to do a little time lapse of me assembling the machine in my studio. So give everybody an idea of what my studio looks like, where I build models, and how easy it is to build a machine like this from a kit that you can buy. In some future videos, I'll actually cover the 3D printing process in a little bit more detail. I'll cover what 3D printing is, and more importantly, what 3D printing is not. Just a little FYI about this video, it's in no way an official guide to how to put this machine together, because I put things together in the wrong order in many cases than what the official way says to do, and some things I had to go back and change. It's just really meant as a general overview of how to put a kit like this together. This rapid prototype machine, or 3D printer, allows me to print layer thicknesses at 50 microns a layer. That's half of a tenth of a millimeter layer thicknesses. That's pretty good resolution for a printer costing under $10,000. It's actually incredible resolution. The build envelope on this machine is 3 inches by 4 inches by 8 inches, so I can't make really big objects, but I can make very, very detailed objects. And most of the product design that I do are handheld products, so the build size is just the right size for me, and I'm really looking forward to some of the stuff that's going to come out of the machine. And some of the samples that I've made so far have been incredible, and I'm really happy with the results that I've gotten so far. I wanted to say a really big thank you for all my followers on YouTube. You guys have been incredible. I've gotten large amounts of followers in the last year, and I can't even believe the amount of followers that I have so far. It's really been pretty exciting, and look for more drawing and design videos for me in the future. There'll be some here obviously on 3D printing. I have some more drawing videos that I haven't put up yet. I've just been super busy with other projects and stuff and other products that are coming out. I've been working on stuff for clients. So just stay tuned, and there'll be more drawing videos soon. If you have some parts that need to be printed, you can contact me through the YouTube page or my Botzen Design website. There's a link there where you can submit your files and you can get a quote for parts. I'd be more than happy to give you a quote on whatever STL files that you submit, and you can get some parts made from this machine. Let's take a look at some parts being made right now. Thanks for watching. Hope you like this video. Look for more to come soon. I want to give a shout out to my buddy Ted and his band Metzger's Field for the music from this video, Simple Bridge. Thank you so much. Thanks for watching, and rock on.